these are the guys that push you, and you got to push them. You know what I mean? Where it's like, but what I've been trying to do in the past few years is like, because I think I was so competitive. I don't know how they would feel. You have to talk to them, but I know for myself, I was so competitive early on that, like, even though we were all friends, I would say we were all friends and friendly. Like, I wasn't, I've never been a reach out, you know what I mean? Like, I never been that person, you know what I mean? Especially when there's competition involved, because it's like, nigga, I'm over here doing what I do, you know what I mean? It's almost like working out together. Like, I guess in the NBA in the past, it was like, that was unheard of. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? Like, why would I work out with this nigga? Like, I'm trying to destroy this nigga, you know what I mean? Like, and that was kind of my mentality. That was kind of my mentality early on. It's like, but as I've gotten older, I realized that, like, yo, actually, it's what you said. No one is truly my peer or can relate to what I'm going through in life more than these people right here. You know what I mean? Because just in terms of whatever pressures there might be, whatever amount of, like, celebrity, which is, you know, a whole conversation in itself, there might be family, you know, privacy, boom, boom, boom. Like, nobody can really relate to that like these dudes. And I really genuinely fuck with these dudes. So, like, mm-hmm. I've been trying to, you know, absolutely make an effort, like, as time goes on, to, like, strip the competition from it. Like, y'all niggas are cemented forever. You know what I mean? Like, I will hope that I'm cemented forever. And if not, I will be, you know, when it's all said and done. You know, in my mind, it's how my mentality is. So it's like, there's, like, the competition part I've stripped away, and I'm now on some shit like, man, I'm more interested in the relationship, because I also see a time when I'm not doing this. That seems very realistic to me. And in a time mm-hmm. when I'm not doing this, I would, you know, I don't want to be like, damn, I never fucked. We never kicked it. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? Like, we never really even did nothing. So, like, I'm at that point where it's like, I'm more interested in the genuine relationship than mm-hmm. before I was interested in the competition. Before I was just interested in, like, putting pressure or responding to pressure. You know what I mean? now it's just like, this is what I'm doing. I know your pressure going to be a whole level of pressure. I know your pressure going to be a whole level of pressure. You know what I mean? And that's it. You know what I mean? Like everybody, it's just less competition in my mind. You know what I mean? Because niggas is old, bro.
It's too stressful to be competing all the time, man.
Man. For real.
Is it a respect thing? Like, you've gotten to the point where you respect what everybody's doing so much. It's like, you know, enough of that. Let's just kind of celebrate what we're doing.
It was always a respect thing, because even at its most competitive, you're not going to be competitive with somebody you don't respect. You know what I mean? You're not going to be extremely competitive with somebody you don't respect. So it's always a respect thing. I think now it's just more of a, like, a wisdom thing, where it's like, yo, you can never have it all. Nope, 100% of the people are never going to say Kevin Durant is the best player walking the face of the earth.
Yep.
100% of people are never going to say J. Cole is the best rapper breathing. You won't get 90%. You won't get 90% to say Drake. You won't get 90% to say Kendrick. It's just never going to happen. You know what I mean? And, like, but as a child, and I say child meaning, like, in your 20s, you think that's attainable. You want all of that. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
I want no doubt, you know what I mean? And, like, now I understand that. Look, I approach my bars from that perspective. I approach my work ethic from that perspective. But the reality of me knows that's unattainable. It's cool to push yourself towards that. But Michael Jordan will never be universally hailed as the greatest player of all time. And that's insane. You know what I mean? Like, and LeBron James will never be universally hailed as the greatest player of all time. And that's insane, viewed from another lens. You know what I mean? So it's like, you'll never have it. You know what I mean? Like, so it comes with age to realize that, like, yo, what are you even, like, worried about? You know what I mean? Because you just set yourself up for suffering. Like, oh, man, they think this nigga harder than me.
That shit is stressful, bro.
You feel like you're in a similar spot, Kev?
Yeah, for
sure.
You
actually compete with them dudes. Like, you'll fuck around and run into them on Saturday and have them score 20, you know what I mean? So score 30 to win. So it's a little bit different, but personal level.
Yeah, it's a little different. I mean, you come into the game wanting that respect from everybody, and in our sport, how you get that respect is just to come with that aggression, you know? So I was just naturally defensive the second I stepped up each level, high school to college, college to the pros. I was just like, everybody out here to get me, you know what I'm saying? Everybody out here to stake their claim as the best. So it's on me to, you know, I gotta be super radical out here. So after a while, I was like, you know, I've been in the league. These guys are actually cool to be around. Being the Team USA, being around these guys for a month, you see the core of who they are. I see LeBron James the second he wake up and come downstairs to the breakfast meeting. I see Kobe Bryant, after dinner with his family. So you see these dudes and you're like, oh, shit, they are humans as well. You know what I mean? Because we look at mythical figures because of our athletic ability. So once I started, it was just a mentality switch in my mind. It was more so like, all right, these dudes are cool. We all, it's a game that we're competing at, and it's me versus the game, not me versus this other person. I'm trying to be the best me I can be, most efficient player I can be. So there's no need for me to be battling with these guys. And competition on the court comes naturally to us. So there's no need for the extras. You know what I'm saying?
Got you. So that's a fact. That helped.